Our project is with sustainable fuels, categorizing the material effects of sustainable fuels on engines. Our project is comparing Jet A, the usual airline fuel, to a new sustainable fuel, HEFA SPK.
We're looking at the O-rings that would be in a typical jet engine, and we're looking to set up a testing apparatus that companies can come to us and say, hey, we have this sustainable aviation fuel and we have these sets of O-rings, and we want you to test them and see how the SAF might affect this type of O-ring. SAF stands for Sustainable Aviation Fuel. And so we're currently working with Pratt & Whitney right now. They gave us some HEFA SAF fuel, and we're using that along with different O-rings that would be used with the SAF.
We're comparing what happens while these O-rings are put into a bath of each of these fuels, and also we're testing to see what happens when there's O-rings in the Jet A bath and then switching over to the HEFA. This will demonstrate kind of the transition as engines switch directly from using Jet A to HEFA in the field. Will HEFA have any detrimental impact on these O-rings, and are the O-rings going to need to be changed before the transition to 100% SAF?
So Jet A has aromatics that will add mass to the O-ring over time, but sustainable aviation fuels don't have the aromatics, so they don't add that mass that creates a greater seal with the O-ring. So we're trying to see how much the aromatics affect the O-ring.
So it rejected it, I hit okay.
Sustainable fuels are important in aviation because there isn't the option for electrification, at least currently, especially in the long distance routes. That's one of the big reasons why sustainable fuels are the short-term, at least, pathway towards net zero carbon emissions.